What up, though? And welcome back to Old School Hip Hop Head Rio Reacts. I also have another YouTube channel called Rio's Reactions. And on that YouTube channel, I'm reacting to 99% old school golden era hip hop. So if you're ever in a mood to watch some old school hip hop reactions, all you have to do is go to the link that I'm going to put in the description of this video. All right, man. Let me see who requested this. All right, man. Yo, so shout out to Sabrina for this request. And so check it. As I was scrolling through YouTube looking for the I Am Tanji American Idol performance, I came across this Joe Rogan clip with, looks like it's Joe Rogan and Jelly Roll having an emotional reaction to I Am Tanji. Yo, I'm a big Joe Rogan fan. I'm a big UFC fan. I've been rocking with Joe Rogan since podcast episode one, and I'm not even joking. It was just him and Brian Redband in a fucking basement or some shit like that. Like, they couldn't even get the pitcher to come on. But anyway, so I've heard, well over 1,000 of his podcasts. So I'm very familiar with Joe, not familiar at all with Jelly Roll. The only thing I know about Jelly Roll is his name. And the crazy shit is, when I first saw this dude, like a picture of him and his name and everything, I thought it was a joke. I thought he was like on some weird Al Yankovic shit, like, you know, like do like fake songs, mock songs, or whatever you call it, parodies and shit like that. You know what I mean? I thought he was one of them type of people, because who the hell would name themselves Jelly Roll? But apparently this guy is a big artist. I just am not familiar with him or his work at all. All right, man. So what we gonna do is we gonna check out this Joe Rogan and Jelly Roll clip. I don't even know if it's going to make it to the actual reaction, because I feel like Joe Rogan's going to get this banned from YouTube if I try to post it. But, you know, we're going to roll the dice and see. And then right after I watch Joe Rogan and Jelly Roll's reaction, I'm going to go right into the actual American Idol performance of I Am Tanji. I hope I'm saying his name right. But anyway, man, without further ado, shout out to Stephanie and to Paul for this request. All right, man, let's get it.
Well, yeah. Yo, let me show you this other kid.
Okay. Yep. He's started off with crying. Right. So.
Yeah, so he was just crying. Watch. Oh,
before they turn off all the lights, I'll tell you good night, close the door.
Look at them chill bars, Joe.
I don't have those.
Is gone, so here it is. I'm not your son, you're not my father. I know your mistakes, and you know mine. While you're sleeping, I try to make you proud. It's my turn to chase the monsters away.
Oh, God, crazy, right? Oh. Tear up every time, dog.
I can only watch it once.
Oh.
Oh my God.
Don't be afraid. It's my turn to chase the.
Where's Simon?
Choked up the whole time.
Holy shit.
How crazy is that, Joe?
Holy shit.
Oh, I'm sorry I did that to us, man.
No, please.
He's
Holy
just
fuck.
So good, man.
That's so good.
I'm like,
he's 18.
He's 18, dude. I'm finna meet this kid this weekend, and I'm literally to the moon about it.
Holy shit, is he good? That's crazy.
I've already publicly put the word out to whoever has the contractual Dang. Rights to him. I want in.
It's what we were talking about, man. That's authentic. Mm. Like, that is, you just can't fake that. Yeah. There's no faking that.
No, just real, man. Just raw. Holy you feel every shit. Piece of it. It takes you to a place.
Oh my God! It tells a story. It takes you to a place.
Yeah. No, man. That's
the voice
power
too.
Music.
Like the. Oh my God! And you know it's coming from him.
Oh yeah. And you could hear the little times where you could hear the tears in his throat, like that distinct sound of fucking them tears in that throat. And dude, losing my father was probably the hardest thing I ever went through as an adult. So hearing this,
man.
All right, man. Yo. There it was, Joe Rogan and Jelly Roll reacting to I Am Tanji. I'm going to be honest. I did not get the emotional reaction that Joe and Jelly Roll got. And it was interesting that both men on the panel, I think it was Lionel Richie. I know it was Lionel Richie. I don't know who the other guy was. The white guy with the dark hair. I have no idea who he was. They both were crying, but the lady wasn't crying. As he was singing, I did come to the realization that, okay, he's singing about his father and his father's dead. But, you know, I probably need more backstory and context. So let's jump right into the actual American Idol performance. And I'm sure they're going to do like an interview and all that kind of stuff to get to know the performer. I am Tanji. And maybe that song will be a little bit more impactful once I actually watch his performance. All right, let's get it.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, I'm good. How are you guys?
Very well. So tell us who you are, where you're from.
My name is Iam Tongi, and I'm from Kahuku, Hawaii.
All right, so I screwed his name up. I don't even know how to pronounce that. Let me hear it one more time.
Where you from?
My name is Iam Tongi, and I'm from...
Iam Tongi.
Kahuku, Hawaii.
Iam Tongi.
Tongi. You pronounce the T's like a D in the Tongan culture.
Oh.
So tell us about your journey. Iam Tongi. How did you get here?
Well, I grew up in Kahuku, which is on Oahu. And I recently, like 3 years ago, I moved to Seattle.
Hey.
You know, it's not the same, but it's still all right.
Well, it's definitely
it's not the same.
It's different right. Weather. Right.
Yeah. Why on earth would you leave Hawaii?
Price out of paradise. That's what it is.
Damn.
Price out of paradise. And
I get it.
Damn, yo.
We fixed it.
Yo, they got, what's the word for gentrification going on all over the place right now, yo. Detroit, Compton, soon to be Watts, Pittsburgh, Chicago. Wow, where are people who are not rich going to live? Wow, he got priced out of Hawaii. Wow.
Get you priced back in Hawaii.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, let's get him priced back in.
I think he should buy
is your
an
family
island.
Wait, what was this?
Most of my mom's siblings, she has 12 siblings. I have family in Hawaii.
A year ago, okay.
We all live in Seattle.
So how, and your dad?
My dad passed away like a couple of months ago.
Oh, a couple months ago.
Sorry, buddy.
Damn.
So who got you into music?
My dad. He taught me.
He's the reason for all this, huh?
A couple months ago.
Okay. What's his name?
Rodney.
Rodney.
Rodney, yeah.
It is?
I can tell he meant a lot to you. Yeah.
Rodney.
I got it, man.
R.I.P. Rodney.
What are you gonna do for us? Take your time. It's okay, man. You know, when you love so deeply, you feel so deeply.
Yeah.
And so what you're just giving us right now is the fact you love that man so much. Okay?
Yeah.
We're there with you.
The song I'll be singing is a song. It's called Monsters by James Blunt.
Monsters.
Now I'm rooting for his ass. See? That's the background and the context.
Okay.
Yeah, so.
Let's go, Donkey.
Dedicating to my dad.
All right.
So whose song is this?
Dedicating to Monsters by James Blunt.
Monsters, okay.
Yeah, so.
I've never heard of James Blunt or the song Monsters.
There's a song, it's called Monsters by James Blunt.
Monsters, okay.
Yeah, it's a song dedicating to my dad.
All right. You want to take a moment? You all right?
Yeah. I'm good, I'm good.
Shout out to the GOAT, Lionel Richie. Legend.
You gotta relax a little.
Before they turn off all the lights, I won't read you your wrongs or your rights. Time is gone. Oh, I'll tell you goodnight, close the door. I'll tell you I love you once more. Time is gone, so here it is. I'm not your son. You're not my father. We're just two grown men saying goodbye. No need to forgive, no need to forget. I know your mistakes and you know mine.
I'll try to make you proud. So daddy, won't you just close your eyes? Don't be afraid. It's my turn to chase the monsters away. Sleep a lifetime. Yes, and breathe a last word. You can feel my hand on your own. Cause I'm not your son, you're not my father. We're just two grown men saying goodbye. No need to forget, no need to forget. I know your mistakes and you know mine. While you're sleeping, I try to make you proud. So daddy, won't you just close your eyes? Don't be afraid. It's my turn to chase the monsters away.
Oh, sorry.
That's all right, man. That's all right, man.
Thank you.
Great job, Donkey.
I was not worried about whether you were going to make it through.
All right, yeah. That backstory makes this way more impactful than just watching Joe Rogan and Jelly Roll react to this blind without any context, you know what I mean? That was very powerful. And shout out to Donkey. Yo, this dude's mad talented. Like Joe said, his voice is amazing. Like, I'm just thinking about, this dude had a move in high school. He's 18 years old. They just moved last year, so he was either 16 or 17. Let's just say he was 17 years old when they moved. You know what I'm saying? Like, imagine yourself, like, in your high school years. Most of us probably went to the same high school all 4 years. And then a lot of people had those same friends in high school that they went to elementary school and junior high school with. So then you just have to up and fucking move, son. Like, your whole life is topsy-turvy, you know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't have handled that situation well. I'd have lost my shit, nigga. I'd have ran away and stayed wherever the fuck I was. Like, that's a very fucked up, delicate situation. And then a year later, his dad dies or something like that? Or did it, you know, I don't know the whole timeline, but he had to move in his high school years and then his father passed away. Like, that whole situation is fucked. So shout out to Donkey to be able to, like, move on. Not move on, but, like, keep on doing the shit he loved, which is sing, focus, you know what I'm saying? And maybe this is what got him through all the hard times, you know what I'm saying? It's his art, him singing, writing. I don't know if he writes music, but, you know, playing music or whatever. So shout out to him, man. Like, this is a very, what's the word for it? Motivational story, you know what I'm saying? And yo, did this guy become famous? It's 2024, so this happened last year. So, like, did he get a record deal? From the sounds of it, Jelly Roll's ready to give him one. And I think there may be a clip where they came back and competed, like, in the finals or something like that. So maybe I do a separate reaction to that. But let's just see how this conversation goes from here.
The song, I was worried about whether we were going to make it through the song. Your daddy's very proud.
Thank you so much.
I mean, what a fantastic song.
Who is this lady?
Oh, I'm telling you.
I feel like you could have written this song.
Thank you.
I mean, you sang it, you delivered it. And
this lady's eyes look amazing. I don't know if it's the color of the, you know, the blue around her eyes, the makeup or whatever the case may be, but damn, she looks like she's straight out of like a movie.
You could have written this song.
Thank you.
I mean, you sang it, you delivered it, and you're making these grown men cry.
What's that guy?
You hit a nerve.
Thank you.
And that's what great storytellers do. That's what great artists do. And your voice is just so magnificent.
It really is.
Thank you.
I cannot handle your heartbreaking about your dad.
Yeah.
All
right, so he's obviously a country western performer, singer.
Just seeing you missing your dad just sucks. And gosh, man, you just got a great voice. You got a great voice.
Thank you.
You just did everything perfect, and I love you, and I want to just want to see you have fun in this whole thing, man.
This is a hell of a guy right here. It's just whoever he is.
Awesome.
Kenny Chestnut?
Just did. I mean, you're 18 years old.
Chestnut?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let me just tell you something. The story is one thing. Your delivery of your story was phenomenal.
Oh, thank you.
Luke, what's your book?
Obviously, I'm a yes.
You're going to be all right, Luke.
I'm a yes.
Luke who?
This one's for Rodney.
Oh. Yeah.
I'm a yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
It's a yes for me. And young man, you take this into the world, and you're going to fracture some souls.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
The greatest thing we can say to you at this moment,
You're going to Hollywood, man.
Okay?
Oh, this was an audition?
Oh, I got to give him a hug.
I know.
No, man, that was awesome, buddy.
Thank you, man.
Great job.
Thank you, man. Great job.
Throughout my life, my dad told me that singing is the only thing.
Oh, there he is. Shout out, Rodney.
The main reason why I did music is because my dad. That's
was that his dad right there, too?
Ever since he passed away.
Was that Rodney?
It's been hard. This one's for Rodden. Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, my dad. Yeah. People thought I cried, you know, because I miss him, but it's because I hear him singing. I can hear his harmony. I can hear, like, how he would harmonize with me in that song. He always wanted me to come to American Idol. See, so I'm trying to make him proud of me. I know he's with me. Through my music, he'll always be with me. Love you, Dad.
R.I.P. Rodney.
You love about
man, yo, there it is. Monsters. Performed by, I can't pronounce his name. Man, my bad. Em Dongi. I think that's how you say it. I'm not for sure, but hey, if anybody's watching this reaction, you're probably an American Idol fan, so you know who this is. And shout out to Stephanie and Paul. I think those are the people who requested this, because I would have never seen this if it wasn't requested. So, all right, man, there it is. Now I got to do some research to see if this guy became see if he's got like a record deal, like if he's got music out and all that kind of stuff. See if he's been on any other shows. All that, you know what I mean? I'm hoping for the best for this guy. All right, man. Yo, on to the next one. I'm out.